Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. This is Sunday Omony. If you're new to my channel, please consider subscribing and be sure to like this video as well. Also, don't forget to hit the notification bell. That way you'll be notified every single time I upload a new video on my channel. And if you'd like to connect with me, you can find me on Instagram at Sunday Omony and on Facebook at Sunday Omony TV. Please excuse my voice. I am still working on it. It's getting better though, and I'm able to talk a lot better than in my previous videos, but I wanted to give you guys a quick update regarding Wendy Williams' movie and the documentary. And I don't want to spoil a lot for any of you who haven't seen it yet, but I'll just tell you some of the things that really stood out to me, and also just some updates based on the video that I did yesterday for you guys in regards to Wendy Williams spray painting, or should I say vandalizing, Mistress Sharina Hudson's dream home that was provided for her by herself, by Wendy, and her now ex-husband, Kevin Hunter, aka Kelvin. So in the film, there were some topics that I thought that was really important, and I'm glad that Wendy, you know, shed light on it. She talked a lot about body issues that she had as a kid, and then her plans to as well, you know, level up and stuff like that after she moved out of her parents' house. She also talked a lot about the dark times in her life and the things that she experienced as well, you know, as a woman, and recommendations from doctors. I appreciate the fact that Wendy still continues to go to therapy until now, because I really think that she needs it. It's very important, and it's vital, very, very vital. The movie was too short, in my opinion. It wasn't as long as I expected it to be. I just wish there was more. Maybe in the future there will be a part two. But it was also really sad to see her dangerous habit as well. So I won't get into too much detail about that. But if you know Wendy, then you know what habit I'm talking about as well. But it was really sad to see how broken Wendy was. And I'm so proud of her, because she could have lost it all. And it's really, it's unfortunate that sometimes when you start something with somebody that you may not, you know, celebrate until the end, like together, because she felt protected by Kelvin, and she also loved how much he was there for her as well. And I think she expected them to be together forever. And when she spray painted the home that he bought for his mistress with her money, she wrote Wendy and Kevin forever, because that's actually what Wendy thought. She was really loyal and she loved with her full heart. But, you know, Kevin, on the other hand, loved variety, obviously. And she's mentioned this in her interviews, that he was a serial cheater, of course. And, you know, recently it appears that she's also trying to tell Sharina something too, that Kelvin hasn't even been faithful to her. But it's just kind of sad how Wendy is always going after Sharina, but never really that much at Kevin. She needs to stop that, because it's Kevin that was not faithful. It's Kevin, or Kelvin, however way you want to call him. But remember, his government name is Kelvin, okay? Stage name, Kevin Hunter. So it's just really interesting how she's always mad at her, but she's not as mad at her ex-husband, because he caused all of this, and she could have lost everything as well if she was not in such control of herself. So I'm really proud of her for that. But I kind of don't like how Wendy's trying to make it seem like as well, like she knew everything that was happening, and that, you know, like she knew everything and she's a smart one, she was 10 steps ahead and everything like that. Yeah, she did know everything, but she decided to be in that toxic relationship. But I guess she kind of wants everyone to think now, like, I knew everything, this was all my plan, I planned to do this, I knew he was doing all of this, but nobody really knew more than I did, kind of thing. And, you know, I had help. I believe that Wendy sold her story, or sent her story over to the tabloids and the Daily Mail or whoever, just so then that way she can have more material for her movie as well as her documentary, because she knew about this affair for 13 to 15 years. or more. She knew about this the whole time. I believe that Wendy thought, you know what, one day I'm going to do a movie about my life and I need content for it. And because of that, I'm going to make sure that all this stuff gets out. Because let's just be honest. Do you really think that just some random person is just going to be following Kelvin around and Sharina Hudson out of nowhere without the help of Wendy or Wendy being involved in it somehow? I believe she was involved in it. But anyways, I would love to hear what you guys have to say down in the comment section. Yesterday, in yesterday's video, I mentioned to you that Wendy's been talking about leaving her talk show. And yes, this is true. She is interested in teaching communications and becoming a professor. That's right, guys. That's the next thing for Wendy, and she's very excited about it. She also wants to get remarried as well. Any gentleman that's 45 years old and up, she is willing to date. She is currently on Bumble, allegedly, as well, and doing her online dating. I don't know how that's working out, especially during this time, but maybe she's just doing it, you know, all online. But what's next for the Wendy Williams show? Who would replace Wendy? We've discussed some ideas that some of you guys have shared with me. You've mentioned Tamar Braxton. Some of you have mentioned Star Jones. But, you know, I was also thinking about here on YouTube and some talents that I've seen that are so out there and so unique and interesting. And I think Tasha K would be really great. Some people call her Tasha. I call her Tasha K. But yeah, she is very unique and she is not afraid. And I feel like she's next. I know that some people don't, you know, appreciate her, but she is very entertaining. She's very funny and she is not afraid of burning bridges with anybody. And that's kind of the Wendy Williams, you know, MO. They just don't care. But I feel like Tasha is a little bit more responsible and has a little bit more heart compared to Wendy, just because Wendy can be very ruthless. But I feel like Tasha cares a little bit more. And remember, she did have a phone call conversation with her ex-husband, Wendy's ex-husband, Kelvin, as well, who called her and they had a discussion. And I could tell that it appeared like he was very excited about Tasha because I think he did see something in her that kind of reminded him of his ex-wife, Wendy. I think that the next Wendy Williams, more than the other suggestions that we've discussed, I think Tasha K should definitely have an opportunity to get that position if possible in the future. Comment down below. Let me know your thoughts. Would love to hear what you guys have to say. And be sure to connect with me on Instagram or on Facebook at Sunday Omony. If you have any video ideas or if there's any topics that you'd like us to discuss on the channel as well. Thank you so much for watching. And thank you to my new subscribers for joining our tribe. I will talk to you in my next video. Until next time. Cheers.